tickets to give away with a great game we're bringing back called Name That Wolf.
Ow, 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 ow.
All you Wolfpack friends trying to join our pack.
Need you now.
We need you now more than ever.
That's right.
We're down 2-0 to those dirty, stinking Hershey Bears.
12,000 fans that just go bananas and get all over those Bears.
And the Hershey
eat them like gummy bears.
Exactly. We eat bears for breakfast around here.
That's right.
So not only do we got to win Wednesday, we got to win Friday, and then we got to win Game 5 back in Hershey in order to move on in the Calder Cup. For the Calder Cup Championship.
Bring it back.
Back
man.
When PJ Stock and Deneen and them boys were down in the streets of Hartford.
I don't think Kevin Deneen ever played
for Hartford. He wasn't on the team.
He was on the Whalers.
Oh.
Not the Wolfpack.
Back when PJ Stock and them boys were running down.
Derek Armstrong's running
down the streets of Hartford with beers in his hand, celebrating like it was 1999 and the Calder Cup was back at home, and it's a rightful spot in the trophy case of the XL Center, trying to get it back. 860-522-3776. We have family.
And Jernander.
Jernander.
Here's our captain.
Oh. Right, he's our captain.
Jernander and them boys. 860-522-3776. Family four-pack, fellas, for Wednesday's game. That's in 2 days. And Name That Wolf is a very fun game. That's just basically wolf trivia. Rob's going to give you a clue about a wolf. You name that wolf, you're going to root on the Wolfpack Wednesday night at the XL Center. Again, we will have multiple choice, so don't freak out if you don't know a lot of wolf trivia. No one does. No one does. Kurt and John are working the phones right now. As Dibs said, we need you now more than ever. Not only are we down 2-0, but the Rangers keep taking all our good players. Duran's going to be wearing a Rangers jersey sitting on the bench just in case Jonathan Quick and or Igor cannot go in net. So we lost a goalie. But that doesn't mean it's over. As long as we believe the Pack can succeed. But we need everybody in the stands going crazy. Okay. You got
nothing's over until we say it's
exactly.
Over.
Exactly. Right.
Remember when the Germans bombed Pearl Harbor?
Exactly.
Forget it. He's rolling.
We have callers ready. We got some people. Okay.
Yes.
860-522-3776. Who's the first one?
Sean.
Sean! What is up, Sean? How you doing, man?
Hey, happy belated birthday, Ben.
Oh, thank you, sir. Excellent. How are the kiddos today? How many days left of school do we have? I know you got that countdown.
18.
I knew he had that countdown. Teachers, man. Teachers. All right, Sean, you have played Name That Wolf before, so you know the game. Dibs is going to give you a clue about a wolf. Wait for the multiple choice. You get it right. We're sending you and your pack to join our pack with the Wolf Pack on Wednesday night, taking on the Hershey Bears. Are you ready, Sean?
Sounds great. Let's do it.
Sean, this man is known for being a wolf man in the X-Men and known to hunt werewolves in his role as Van Helsing. Who is he? A. Stu Blackman. B. Hugh Jackman. C. Jack Parkman.
B. Hugh Jackman.
Yeah.
All right. Way to get the party started, Sean.
That was a pretty easy one.
That was a little bit of an easy one. Stay on hold, Sean. Going to hook him up with 4 tickets to the Wolf Pack. Bring his pack with our pack against Hershey Bears and the Wolf Pack. Stu Blackman, I made up, Dibs. Do you know who Jack Parkman is?
I do know a Stu Blackman, by the way.
Who is?
Jack Parkman is from Major League.
Nail on the head. He was that dirty White Sox that was just a thorn in the side of the Wild Pack.
He was an Indian. He was on the Indians. They traded him to the White Sox.
His shimmy makes people sick in Cleveland, it was told.
Mm-hmm. Don't stand on the track when
I
the
love
train's
him,
coming
too.
Through,
he's a great bad guy. He was also in Officer and a Gentleman.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's... Yeah.
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 Who's Stu Blackman?
Stu Blackman was a baseball player.
There really was a Stu Blackman?
Stu Blackman.
It sounded familiar in my ear. I was like, I know a Stu Blackman.
Charlie Blackman plays for the Rockies.
That's the one I was trying to think of today. I was like, I know there's an
He looks like Blackman. Grizzly Adams.
Yes. He looks like a werewolf.
Looks like Marsh from the Phillies.
Marsh and Blackman.
This guy's hair
could
always
both
looks
be werewolves and
wet.
We don't know it.
They're like wrestlers. Remember how wrestlers always had wet hair?
Yeah. What is that? Is that product?
I think they do that. I'm sure you can put product in it to make it look like that, but I think they wet their hair for the effect.
I feel like they stay in the swamp until game time.
And there was a guy with a toothpick that was from the old WWE.
UL Washington? Oh, no, that was the baseball player.
Dusty Baker?
Oh, that was the baseball coach. That's the baseball coach, right?
All right, let's move on. 860-522-3776. Still naming that Wolf. Kurt, who's next?
Tom's on, too.
All right, Tom. How's you doing, Tom?
Good, good. Hopefully you guys give me one as easy as the last one.
Oh, possibly, because this name has been mentioned already during the show. Name that wolf. Rob's going to give you a clue about a wolf. You name that wolf, we're sending you the game. Are you ready, Tom?
Yep.
All right, Tom. Coming to Hartford from Vancouver, Canada, this goalie was in net for the Wolfpack in the 4-2 loss this past Saturday. Who is he? A, Dylan Garand, B, Igor Fritz, C, Jaime Dominguez.
Igor Fritz.
I don't even think that's one of our goalies,
back.
Is it?
No, it is not one of the our goalies.
The other two are.
Now, Jaime Dominguez is really just a name I made up. Tried to fool you with Dominguez and Dominguez.
Yes.
And did not get Tom on that. However, I did get Tom on the name that is disputed of Dr. Frankenstein's right-hand man. So some stories have it as Igor. Some stories have it as Fritz. So there I put Igor Fritz. Dylan Gerond is our actual.
And he just got called up to the Rangers.
I know. And
Ben put that in there early in the show.
I know.
I did know that.
Ah.
And I didn't know he was one of our goalies. So that's you actually schooled me on that.
There you go. There's a guy that.
Got to listen to this show, man. Ben's always got some like things.
Sneaking in clues.
Yeah, he's got threads
later.
That he just.
Threads. Yes.
Threading.
It's like Hansel and Gretel breadcrumbs trying to lead you to the slaughter.
I love how he picked Igor Fritz.
I learned a lot about Igor Fritz, too, today. It's or Fritz
well,
slash
Well, and Van
Ego.
Helsing, too, like the bad guy that he's fighting. You know, Igor's, like, messing with the werewolf in it. And he's like, Igor, why do you always do that?
Forgot about that.
Master, that's what they always do.
Mm-hmm. Igor Fritz does sound like a good goalie, though.
Yeah.
Always on his toes. 860-522-3776. Kurt, who's next?
Will.
Will.
Hello, Will.
Thank you for holding. Thank you for listening to our.
Yes, sir.
Name that wolf, Will. Dibs has got a clue about a wolf. You name that wolf, we're sending you the game. Are you ready, sir?
Yep.
Will, in this cartoon, the big bad wolf cannot contain himself as he watches the attractive singer on stage. What is the name of the cartoon?
Whoa.
Is it A, Big Bad Wolf Jazz, B, Red Hot Riding Hood, C, Club Droopy?
Oh, man. Never heard of none of these. Gonna go with B.
Yeah.
Great right. Guess. Excellent job. Great job, Will. Stay on hold. Get some
there's
information
a will, there's
this
a way.
Man. Yes, that is Red Hot Riding Hood. You remember the cartoon. This doesn't really, like, it's kind of like a long-form cartoon where the wolf is, like, shows up to the nightclub and all of a sudden Red Riding Hood comes out and she's hot. That's why it's called Red Hot Riding Hood. And he just can't keep his eyeballs in his head. He actually goes so crazy, he kills himself. And then his spirit rises from his body and then can't contain himself because he sees Riding Hood as well. So, great.
Did you see this in Montreal?
No. This is like an old.
Sounds like a triple X movie.
This is like Mask. Jim Carrey kind of did a play on this.
Not Little Red Riding Hood?
You have seen this cartoon. This is a classic cartoon. And the reason I put Club Droopy in it, this is.
Is his heart like pounding out of his chest? Okay,
yes.
I have seen this. You're
his
right.
His eyeballs pop out.
Yep.
Like,
he's like, oh my God. Oh my God.
His mouth turns into a trumpet where he goes, ow.
That's right. Auga. Auga. I have seen that.
This is the first.
That's old school.
It
right
is
there.
One of the oldest ones. Some forms are in black and white. Now,
wow.
I put Club Droopy because this is the first cartoon where you get Droopy, the dog. He is
yep.
one of the waiters.
Droopy dog,
in,
yep.
The first.
Wow, voices. You're connecting a lot of dots.
We're
here.
Learning a lot on the Rob Dibble Show.
I
we always
it.
Do.
I love it.
All right, we got
I love
Sean
Droopy
to the
dog.
Game.
Droopy dog's always like. Really, like, laid back and slow.
Almost too laid back.
That's right.
Almost too laid back.
But Will got it.
Congratulations, Will. Congratulations, Sean. All right, Kurt, who's been listening to this the whole time just waiting for us to shut up?
So hello, can... Lewis. Thank you.
All right, Lewis. What is up, Lewis?
How you doing, fellas?
Good. Doing well. All right, name that wolf, sir. Dibs has got a clue. Wait for the multiple choice. You name that wolf, you're going to the game. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
This kind of wolf, Lewis, is found all over Asia. They are an endangered species. There are only 2,500 left in existence. What's the wolf called? Is it A, Dole? Is it B, Warg? Is it C, Chinese Jackal?
B.
Lewis, try back tomorrow. That was a tough one, Dibs. That was
Did I mispronounce
that? The bunch. No, I think you pronounced Dole? It right. I was hoping you mispronounced it and said D-hole.
D-hole.
D-holes are, or doles.
D-holes.
Doles are in Asia, all over Asia, whether you go to China, in the Middle East, or even down south in India, you will find some doles. And they are kind of like a crossbreed of dog and coyote, and they actually compete with tigers and leopards for prey. And they are I think they're...
Doles do not have natural predators except us.
Mm-hmm. They're kind of like a mean dog that doesn't want to get domesticated.
He looks mean.
Mm. Try back.
Kind of like a dingo.
Kind of like a dingo. We will have some Name That Wolf tomorrow for you boys and girls to play. But congratulations, Will. Congratulations, Sean. We're hooking them up with family four packs to go to the game on Wednesday, where we need a win just to survive. Anyway? I think I went to Kind of Wolves in the World, and D-hole popped up.
So, it's a dog-like animal in the mountains. It is not a true dog. Its closest relatives are painted dogs of Africa and bush dogs of South America.
And sums up with its teeth, too. Like, it doesn't have fangs or, like, back molars. Like, it's like a weird, like, little... Kind of like a hyena. All the teeth are sharp. I don't want to run into one. It's like one of your fisher cats out here. I don't want to meet one of these things. A D-hole.
But I'm looking at some of these other... Yeah, the African wild dog, man. That looks like a cross between a hyena and a dog.
Now, warg is a thing. The B...
The warg?
The thing Lewis selected that was the wrong answer. The warg is still... running around out there.
What's a warg?
That's crazy.
A warg is in the Tolkien Lord of the Rings. He is like
J.R.R. Tolkien's Middle Earth fiction. Large and evil kind of wolf that can be ridden by the orcs.
Yes.
So he's a giant wolf.
He was the wolf the orcs rode. That was a warg.
Nice.
Not a D-hole, but a warg. The D-holes, those are real. Wargs make believe.
That's not a happy animal.
No.
The warg?
The warg.
Warg is an angry. It's like a horse.
Is it made out of mud? Because the orcs are made out of mud.
Yeah. Where did they come from?
Yeah. How do you make a warg? It's obviously a mammal. So there's female wargs. There's male wargs. I don't want to have to teach the kids how the babies are made. But it's not made from mud. I'm just saying that. There has to be mama wargs and papa wargs.
Man, you dug deep for today's thing.
Well, we've really run out of wolves. Like, we've done Teen Wolf. We've done a lot of the werewolves in London. We've done Warren Zevon.
Yeah.
We've done.
I think you should, though, start getting deep into the Teen Wolf movies.
Teen Wolf?
What's the dad's name?
Ooh.
What's the mom's name?
What's
the girlfriend's name?
Do your homework.
What's his buddy's
name? There ain't
a
mom.
His buddy.
There's not a mom?
Yeah, there's a mom.
There's a mom?
In Teen Wolf? Absolutely.
Do you guys ever see the cartoon? There was a cartoon of Teen Wolf.
Really?
Like, when Teen Wolf became really popular in the 80s, Michael J. Fox and whatnot, like, late 80s Saturday morning cartoons, there was a Teen Wolf version. And then Teen Wolf 2. What's the guy's name? We did this as well.
Bateman.
Yeah, Jason Bateman. He's Teen Wolf 2.
It was lousy.
Now, isn't Francis from Pee-wee Herman's Big Adventure Michael J. Fox's best friend? I forget what his name is.
Chubbs?
Thank you. Chubbs.
Thank you. Not that Chubbs. Well, different done. Chubbs.
Right.
Mark Holton, by the way, in the movie is Chubby.
Is that Chubbs?
I don't think that's Chubbs.
There's a Chubby and a Chubbs? We're learning so much today.
We are.
We're in the deep end.
I know. That's where Name That Wolf takes you, man. You know, you start talking hockey, then all of a sudden you get into Middle Earth, and then you're talking old 1940s cartoons, and then all of a sudden you end up in Teen Wolf 2. That's what happens in Name That Wolf. It's a great segment.
Of course, the Teen Wolf 2 did have The Land of a Thousand Dances in it, which is a great song.
By the way, his buddy was Jerry Levine. Styles Stalinski.
Yes.
Styles. That's the annoying Styles. Guy, yeah. His annoying pal.
Right. Yeah. He was the guy that drove the van while yes. Michael J. Fox is doing flips while the van is going down the road.
I like Jim McCrell, the vice principal. He was the one that never really liked the Teen Wolf. He's the one that the father growls at him and shows his eyes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's a good movie.
All right, I'll get back into some Teen Wolf tomorrow. Tomorrow we got more tickets to give away, so right around the 5 o'clock hour, be listening. For
always be listening around 5 o'clock because yeah. Mike Crispino might join us he did a couple hours ago, so we're going to replay that for you. Mike Crispino talked about the UConn baseball tournament. The Big East tournament is coming up on Wednesday, and we got schooled by all the great players on UConn baseball this year. So Mike Crispino coming up next on the Bobby V's Hotline.